Welcome to the part 2 of installing SQL Server Payload Cluster on multi-subnet environment. So, as you can see, I have virtual machines installed on my laptop and I'm using VMware Workstation, but we'll be focusing mainly on these three VMs: DOGC, DCGO, Node1GO and Node2GO. So these are my three virtual machines that we'll be doing demo on. And before proceeding, I want to show you the configuration and about the how the network cards are interrelated to each other. So first I'm going to show you the settings of DCGO. So as you can see, I have network adapter 1 and 2. I have two network adapters. So network adapter, the first one has VMNet2 virtual network, and second adapter has VMNet3 virtual network. So this is GODC configuration about the networks. Then we have to go to node 1 setting, then we'll be selecting VMNet2 for the view node 1 and VMNet3 and VMNet3 for the node geo 2. Now I'm going to show you the virtual machines. I'm about to start these machines. So first I'll be starting DOGC, then I'll be starting node 1 and then node 2. So as you can see, right now I'm at DCGO1. All the machines have been started. One more thing I would like to show you is, if I go to the properties and if I check the host name is DCGO for the DCGO machine, and if I go to Node1 and look for host name, Node1 has Node1GO name, and if I go to Node2GO, it has Node2GO name as its hostname. So now first we are going to configure the network. We can type ncpa.ctl. okay, so we have Ethernet 0 and Ethernet 1. So for 0, let's rename it to 192.168.52.1 and 192.168.53.1. So this will be our one subnet and this will be our another subnet. So I'm going to specify the IPs. So 192.168.52.1, and for that DNS 127.0.0.1, and hit OK. Okay, and close. And for this, we'll be installing 192.168.53.1. Now we are going to Node1GO, and over here again type ncpa.ctl, start not home. So we'll be renaming the as well. So this is the 52 subnet 168.52.2, and for the time being over here we'll be typing 192.168.52.1. Okay, okay, and close. 192.168.52.2. So this was GeoNode 1. Now I'm going to Node 2 Geo and CPA.CDO. This will be 192.168.53.2. Go to properties. 192.168.53.2. 192.168.53.1. Hit OK. Now come to DCGO1, and now we are going to install a feature for Active Directory services. So over here you can see add roles and features. You can click on that, click next, next, okay, next. So we want Active Directory domain services. Click on add feature and click next. We required .NET 3.5 feature in Node 1 Geo and Node 2 Geo in order to install SQL services, but this is the domain controller, so we can skip it and install. So as you can see, has been started installing. So I'm pausing this video and I will get back to you once the installation has been completed. So as you can see, the installation for Active Directory domain services has been completed. So hit close and let's switch to new screen. And what's that? Okay, so now you can see promote this server to a domain controller. So click on this. And we want to add a new forest, so let's take contoso.com as our domain name. Hit next and wait. Enter the password. You can type it here, any password. Hit next. Hit next. It should pick the NetBIOS name automatically. So hit next. And again, next, next, and this time we're going to install. And as you can see, if you click install, the server automatically reboots at the end of the promotion operation. So click install. And
I'll be back when the installation completes. So first let the installation start, and then I'll be back after the installation completes. So we are back, and as you can see, we have Contoso. This is the domain. So let's try to ping 192.168.52.2, I guess. It's unable to ping. Okay. So as you can see, it's unable to ping. Now, let's add this node, that is node 1, geo2, to the domain. And how to add a node to a domain? Just simply right click on this PC, go to properties, change settings, and before that, first we will ping 192.168.52.1. So as you can see, we are having reply from the domain. And before that, make sure, what are the IP addresses? It's 52.2, right? Yeah, it's 52.2. So I'm going to change, adding it to domain contoso.com, and click OK. Then we have to add the administrator password. So this will add node 1 geo to the domain controller. And after that, for the simplicity, we are going to disable our firewall. In real environment, you have to check the port numbers required, and you have to enable them at the firewall level. But over here, what I'll be doing is I'll be disabling the firewall. So Windows firewall, turn Windows firewall off. Yes, now we are ready to restart this machine. Now we move towards node 2 geo. And over here we have to do the same configuration that we have done with node 1 geo 168.53.1. And one more interesting thing, like if you try to ping from 52 series, nope, you're not gonna do that. So to make sure we have correct IP addresses, yes, we do have 53.2, and now go to the properties, change setting, change, go to domain contoso.com /administrator password. And wait. as you can see, this node has been added to the domain. So we'll be restarting it later. First we have to disable the firewall. So Windows firewall. Search Windows firewall. Go to Windows firewall, turn off this, this and this one. Now we can shut down or we can restart what I've done, our server. Okay. Yeah. So let's move to node 1. As you can see, this is node 1 geo/administrator. So we want to log in as domain account. Contoso administrator. Yep. So meanwhile we go to the domain controller node and then we ping node 1 geo, and you can see we have reply from node 1 geo. And meanwhile, yeah, this has been started too. We're going to log in as administrator over here as well. Yes. Again, go to the domain controller. Try to ping node 2 geo. Hooray! Okay. So now, till now, what we have done, we have configured a domain controller, added both the nodes into that domain controller. That's it. Now, if I go to this is node 1 geo, and if I try to ping node 2 geo, what it says? Ping could not found node 2 geo. Why? Because there is no routing configured on domain controller. Now we have to tell domain controller if node 1 tries to search node 2, so you have to communicate them. And if node 2 tries to contact node 1, we have to communicate them. So we have to create a link. So in order to do that, we are going to GeoDC. So in order to install routing services, this demo will be shown in the next part.